What's up everybody, Tech Guy Charlie here, welcome back to the channel. So the official stable version of One UI 3 or the Android 11 update is finally available for the Galaxy Note 10 Plus, and in this video I'm gonna show you everything that is new with this update. Oh, and the time code is in the video description, in case you wanna skip to any particular part you can easily do that. So I'm gonna start this video off by showing you guys the major changes, and then gradually we will move on to the smaller ones. So first off, we now have widgets on the lock screen as well as on the always on display, making sure that the always on display is turned on. Now let me put my phone to sleep and wait for the always on display clock to appear. Now on the always on display clock, double tap and then swipe down like this, and this will open up widgets on the always on display. So you've got your music player, you can seek through the song, play pause buttons, you've got your today's schedule, next alarm, weather and the digital well-being widget. Now these widgets are also available on the lock screen, so let me wake the phone up, and if I tap on the clock, this also opens up the widgets on the lock screen. Again, it's the exact same thing. If you want to reorder these, or if you want to disable or enable specific widget, you can just tap on settings, it's unlock, and from over here you can just reorder them, or if you don't like a widget, you can easily go ahead and disable that. So this is a new feature that One UI 3 brings to the Galaxy Note 10 Plus. Guys, if you enjoy watching my videos, do make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to me on my YouTube channel and hit the bell icon so that you can get notifications for my latest uploads, and also follow me on my social media accounts. I will put all the links in the video description. Alright, let's continue. One UI 3 also brings plenty of visual upgrades. You'll notice that the drop-down notification panel is now translucent, and it's always translucent, so even when you have an app open, you'll notice it's still translucent. On the previous version, it was completely opaque, so if you have dark mode turned on, the background will be black. If you switch dark mode off, the background will be white. So if you turn off dark mode, you can see it's still translucent. So that's a nice change. And also you will notice that the animation is slightly different when you drop down the notification panel. It kind of fades onto the screen rather than just scrolling down like it used to on the previous version. So slight change over here. I think this new version is slightly better. It makes the phone feel a lot more graceful. And speaking of different animations, when you open up the recents, so I've got some applications open up in the recent, you'll also notice that the animation is slightly different over here. So on this one, it just swipes like this. This one kind of focuses on the app that is in the middle. One UI 3 update also brings double tap to sleep. So if you double tap on an empty area on your home screen, the screen turns off, and we already had double tap to wake. So now you have both double tap to wake and double tap to sleep. Now to enable double tap to sleep, you'll have to go to settings, scroll down to advanced features, and then tap on motion and gestures, and just turn on double tap to turn off screen. So this is the feature that allows you to switch the screen off by double tapping empty area on your home screen. Very, very useful. Dynamic lock screen has also been updated, and Samsung has introduced 5 new categories. So this is the special category. Let's go to dynamic lock screen settings. So as you can see, there are a lot more categories for wallpapers. Previously we had 5, now we have 10. What's new over here is that now you can select more than one category. So I can have multiple categories selected, and the phone will shuffle wallpapers between the selected categories. And also you might have noticed, now you can change the category right from over here. Tap on this. You don't even need to unlock the phone to change the dynamic lock screen wallpapers. One UI 3 also introduces a new way to add widgets to the home screen. So now if an app supports a widget, all you have to do is long press an application and you will see widgets right over here. Just tap on this, and that's how you can add widgets directly from the app icon. The traditional way of adding widgets is by pinching in, then going to widgets and selecting a widget from this list. But with the latest update, if an app supports a widget, you can just long press, then just tap on widgets, and that will add a widget to your home screen. Samsung has also redesigned and repositioned the volume controls that appears when you press the button. So instead of appearing here at the top, it appears near the button, so it's easier for your thumb to change the volume. And you can press on these three dots and that opens a more detailed volume control panel. And you can also notice that the volume control panel is translucent and you can mute by pressing the speaker icon. And this is your live caption feature right over here, and pressing the gear icon takes you to the main volume controls. Oh, and fun fact, the Galaxy Note 20 Ultra has the volume control button on the right, the Note 10 Plus has it on the left. So on the Note 10 Plus, it appears on the left side of the screen, but on the Note 20 Ultra, it appears on the right side of the screen because that's where the volume button is. Samsung has also improved the way the phone displays and handles notifications in the drop-down notification panel. If you have a music player running in the background, you'll have the music player notification right over here. Now, what's new over here is that you can expand this and then you have the music seek controls right over here in the drop-down notification panel. Previously, we didn't have this. So on the previous One UI 2.5, we don't have the music player seek controls. You actually have to open up the application to see the seek controls. And you also have these seek controls on the always on display widgets. So double tap on the clock, swipe down, and then you can also seek through your song on the always on display. No need to wake your phone up. And I've also noticed that the phone also groups up different types of notifications. So for all your text messages, these notifications will be grouped up into conversations, as you can see right over here. And then you have your alerting notification and then the silent notifications. This wasn't the case before. So all said and done, the newer version is much more smarter. I think this is a good idea to group up different types of notifications together. And speaking of notifications, now you also have notification history. So we will go to settings, tap on notifications, scroll down to advanced settings, and then over here you have notification history and you can check all your recent notifications right from over here. Very useful in case you have missed out on an important notification. You also might be wondering, where did edge lighting go? Because on the One UI version 3, you don't have edge lighting under the display and then edge panel. On the previous version, you had the edge lighting under the edge screen settings inside the display settings. Because on the newer version, the edge lighting has been moved to notifications. So go to settings, tap on notification, then tap on brief pop-up settings, and over here you have edge lighting style. So edge lighting has been moved from the display settings inside the notification settings. I think this is a better option because, hey, edge lighting is in fact notifications. Also, please make sure that this notification pop-up style is set to brief. This is your edge screen lighting. If you set this to detailed, edge lighting will not work. So check this out. I've set this to detailed and the edge lighting will not work. As you can see, no edge lighting. But once I set this to brief and send a text, you'll see that the edge lighting works even when the screen is off, like it should. There you go. So make sure that this notification pop-up style is set to brief and included apps is set to all to make edge lighting work. Now inside notifications, if you scroll down to advanced settings and under floating notifications, you'll see a new option here called bubbles. Now this gives you a Facebook Messenger style notifications. I'm not a huge fan of this, but let me demonstrate this for you. And by the way, this only works for text messages. I could not get the bubbles option to work with any other messenger like WhatsApp or Snapchat. So I'll send myself a text message and you will see what's different. So there you go. You have this bubble style of notifications, very similar to Facebook Messenger. And if you tap on this, this will open up the message and you can reply, send the text. And once you are done, that thing closes by itself. So these are bubbles. I think these are completely useless because Samsung already has something very similar which works with different applications. So again, we will go to advanced settings and the smart pop-up view is Samsung's version of the bubbles. And you can also make this work with different messenger applications. So now let me text myself on WhatsApp and I will show you. So there you go. This is Samsung version of bubbles. So this is called smart pop-up view and we have had this feature for a very long time, much before that bubbles thing was introduced on Android 11. So here's an interesting feature. This update allows you to set a custom video or a still image as your calling screen background. So right now I'm receiving a phone call and you can see a video is playing back. So let me show you how to do this because it's kind of awesome. On your phone, open up the dialer, then press on these three dots and then select settings. Then tap on call background. Over here, you have two options, layout and background. So you can also change the layout. So this is the second layout, but we want to change the background. So I will tap on background and then press on the plus icon. Just pick a video or a still image from your gallery. I'll just pick this video for demonstration. Now it says here video is too large, so we are going to crop this. So after cropping the video, you also have an option, use video sound as ringtone. So you can actually use the video sound as a ringtone, but I'm going to leave this option unchecked. And that's it, set as calling screen background. So now whenever you get a phone call, that video is going to play as the calling screen background. Or if you set a still image, you'll see a still image as the background. And you will also see the background whenever you make a phone call. So right now I'm making a phone call from this phone and you can see we have a custom background instead of the default blue background. So this is a really cool feature. I love this. The power saving modes have also been redesigned on One UI 3. So what I'll do is drop down the notification panel and we will go to the power saving mode. So this is how it looks like now. Previously it used to look like this. The thing is, all of these power modes are still available on One UI 3. They have just been renamed and relocated. So let me try and explain how it works on One UI 3. So when the power saving mode is off, the phone will be in optimized mode, just like it is on One UI 2.5. When you switch on power saving mode, it will go into medium power saving. It will turn off always on display, limit CPU speed, and decrease the brightness, which is same as the medium power savings mode. Now, as for maximum power savings, when you switch on limit apps and home screen, that is your maximum power saving mode on One UI 3. So let me demonstrate. I will switch these on and also notice the difference in speed. Switching between the maximum power saving mode and optimized takes a lot of time on One UI 2.5. On One UI 3, it's almost instant, so you guys can see it is the exact same thing. And you guys will see the difference in speed. Bam! One UI 3 is already back to normal. And as for high performance mode, what I want you guys to do is drop down the notification panel and then tap on these three dots and then select edit buttons and drag and drop enhanced processing over here. So enhanced processing is nothing but your high performance mode. They have just renamed this. If you don't find enhanced processing over here, go to settings, scroll down to battery and device here, then tap on battery, scroll down to more battery settings, and you will find enhanced processing over here. Get faster data processing for all apps except games. This uses more battery, so it's nothing but your high performance mode. Now coming to the battery usage in device care, you will also notice that they have made some changes over here. So you have usage since last full charge and the traditional day wise use. So over here on One UI 2.5, you just have last 7 days of usage and the phone does not show you the screen on time since last full charge. But this one does. So if you tap over here, this will take you to this screen which says since last full charge. So we have a screen on time of 3 hours and 4 minutes. Previously, you had to add that manually. Now coming to the battery life, you can see my screen on time is 3 hours and 4 minutes with 44% charge remaining. But do keep in mind, I have the phone's brightness set to 80%. So that will quickly drain the battery because I am recording the videos. But all said and done, I'm quite happy with the battery backup of the Note 10 Plus on One UI 3. So let's go to the gallery and let me show you a couple of changes over here. First off, you'll notice that the menu button is now down over here. So you have to tap this to open up the menu and this kind of makes it easier to navigate with your thumb. Another change you will notice is that the zooming in and zooming out animation is slightly different. This one kind of feels a little bit more smooth than it did before, but I personally used to like the old animation. I think the old zooming in and zooming out animation looks a lot better than the new one. Another very important change you will notice is that now the image editor can revert the photo back to its original form even after saving the photo that you have edited. So there you go, we have now reverted the photo back to its original form. Let me show you. So this is our photo. I will press on the pencil icon over here to get into the image editor. This is my friend's cat. So I will crop the photo. and I will also apply a filter. Let's apply the warm filter, and I will now save the photo. And you will also notice that the image editor did not create a separate copy of the photo like it used to do on One UI 2.5. It has edited the original photo and saved it. Now the great part is that you can go back into the image editor and revert all the changes that you have done. So there you go, the photo is now back to its original form, and then you can save it. And as you can see, the photo is back to its original form. But if you want to create a separate copy of your edited photo, you can still do that. So we will go back into the image editor. I will crop. Let's apply a filter. Right, so now instead of pressing this save button, I will tap on these three dots and we will select save copy. So that actually creates a separate copy of the photo. You can see this is a separate copy and the original photo is right over here. So that's a very important change in the photo editor. I think you guys will absolutely love this because it doesn't create a separate copy. Plus, if you want, you can always restore the original version. Guys, if you use Samsung keyboard, I think you're gonna love these next few features. First off, Samsung keyboard will now auto suggest emoji, bitmoji, and stickers based on what you are typing. So I'm gonna type smile, and you can see keyboard is automatically suggesting bitmoji, and you also have emoji over here. So I can just tap and send it over. So to make the auto suggest feature work, you might wanna go to the Samsung keyboard setting and make sure suggest stickers while typing is enabled, turn on bitmoji, or else turn on AR emoji. So that's pretty much all you need to do. And now whenever you type something, the bitmoji will automatically appear right over here and you can just send it over to your friend. Awesome, right? One more change in Samsung keyboard is that whenever you copy some text, say let's copy this part, copy, it will appear on top of the keyboard right over here. So you no longer have to long press and then paste. You can just tap over here and that's it. So check this feature out, guys.
G-A-L-A-X-Y Galaxy.
So as you can see, whenever I type something, the phone reads the alphabet and the word out aloud. This feature is called Speak Keyboard Input Aloud, and you can enable this from the keyboard settings. So tap on the gear icon and head on into the Samsung keyboard settings, then scroll down and then tap on swipe, touch and feedback. And from over here, enable this feature which says speak keyboard input aloud. And you might want to select characters and words. If you just want the phone to read characters, select characters. If you just want the phone to read words, select words, but I prefer both. And that's it. Switch it on. And now whenever you type something, the phone will read the alphabet.
H-E-Y. Hey.
And the word out aloud. You might have noticed the menu that pops up whenever you want to share a photo, video, or pretty much any file on your phone. So this menu contains a list of applications and actions that you can use to share a photo or pretty much any file on your phone. What's new in One UI 3 is that now you can pin applications over here. On the previous version of Android, it would show you your recently used applications. Now say for example, I want to share this photo on Snapchat, but I don't have Snapchat over here. I will have to look for Snapchat and there it is. But on this version, I can have the app permanently pinned over here. So it's easier to share stuff. And the way you pin applications to this list is by long pressing and then select pin. That's it. And now you will have the application or an action pinned over here permanently. So these were about 21 major changes that the One UI 3 update or the Android 11 update brings to the Galaxy Note 10 Plus. And now we will go over the minor changes. But first, a lot of you guys have been asking me how to check what's new with the update. So drop down the notification panel, go to settings, scroll all the way down, tap on software update, and then tap on last update. And this is the list that shows you what's new with an update. All right, so moving on. Let's go to the camera because I've noticed something different. First off, they haven't really added any more camera modes, so everything is the same like it was before. But what's new over here is that when you tap, you get this circle and you get a lock icon. And pressing the lock icon will lock the autofocus and the exposure. So you can see it's not readjusting, and you can change the exposure from this little slider. Now on One UI 2.5, you would long press and then the phone would lock the autofocus and the exposure, and then you can use this slider to control the exposure. So it's like an old wine in a new bottle. They have just redesigned how it works. And other than that, there is nothing really new when it comes to camera features. Everything is exactly the same like it was before. But One UI 3.1, which is coming soon, will bring a new camera feature that will allow you to use the front and the rear camera together. So you will be able to use both the cameras to record a video. So I am really, really looking forward to that. And moving on, they have also added recycle bin in the text messaging app. So now whenever you delete a message, it will go into the recycle bin rather than getting deleted permanently. And you can tap on these three dots, go to recycle bin and restore the message right from over here. And also messages in the recycle bin will be permanently deleted after 30 days. So that's a nice addition to the text messaging app. And this one you already might have noticed, but the digital well-being widget is slightly different. It's way more advanced. So you now have a colored bar that shows you your daily usage. Previously, we just had the screen on time and the number of times you unlocked the phone. So this is a little bit more detailed. And if you're not using digital well-being, I suggest that you do, because it helps you keep a track on how much you have been using your phone. And if you want to check the number of times you've unlocked the phone, it is right over here. Also inside digital well-being, the wind down mode is now called bedtime mode. So it's the exact same thing. They have just renamed it. There's also a new option in the contacts or the phone book, which allows you to delete duplicate contacts. So inside the contacts, open this menu and go to manage contacts, and you will notice a new option, delete duplicate contacts, which wasn't there before. So let's go to contacts or phone book here, manage contacts, and you can see delete duplicate contacts is not there. So this will allow you to delete all the duplicate contacts in your phone book. So I'm gonna delete this. So that just cleans up the clutter inside the phone book. Android Auto is also now a part of the Android system. So we will drop down the notification panel, go to settings, scroll down to advanced features, and you will see Android Auto over here. So Android Auto is pretty much like Apple CarPlay. It allows you to view maps, play music, make phone calls from your car stereo. Obviously, you'll need a compatible car stereo, but it's an awesome feature. On the previous version, you would have to separately download it from the Play Store. Now it's included with the Android itself. Samsung has also improved the Bixby routine feature. So inside the same advanced features, go to Bixby routines, and this is how it looks like now. Now I'm not going to show you this feature in more detail because that will take a lot of time. I've already done that. So this is how it used to look like on One UI 2.5. This is how it looks like now. So we are almost at the end of the video. And finally, I would like to go over some of the features that have been removed or are missing compared to the earlier version. First off, the option to hide the camera cutout is no longer there. So if I drop down the notification panel, go to display, scroll down to full screen apps, you might have noticed that three dots are missing. So on One UI 2.5, if you go to full screen apps, first off, let me turn dark mode off so you can actually see the camera cutout. So this is the Galaxy S10 Plus. You have the camera cutout right over here. So inside full screen apps, if I tap on these three dots, go to advanced settings, you have the option of hiding the camera cutout. And if you enable this, this top part of the screen will be switched off. And you can see the camera cutout is no longer visible, but you do have a bit of top bezel. Some people like to use this feature, and unfortunately, Samsung has removed this. And lastly, another feature I have noticed that is missing is Wi-Fi Direct. So if I try and share this photo on a phone running One UI 2.5, you have Wi-Fi Direct. On One UI 3, you no longer have this feature. But that really isn't a problem because there are plenty of alternatives available. Samsung is already suggesting that you use Nearby Share instead of Wi-Fi Direct. And to be honest, Wi-Fi Direct has never really worked properly, at least on my end. So using Wi-Fi Direct, I'm not even able to view the photo on my TV. Instead, I use something called Smart View. And for sharing files, there's already Quick Share available on the phone. Alright guys, thank you for watching this video. Hope it was helpful. If it was, make sure to hit the like and subscribe to the channel for more content. And if you have any doubts or questions, leave them in the comment section down below and I'll try and answer them. So thank you guys for watching. Stay tuned for more videos like these and I will see you guys next time.